Using the theorem of residues, we can compute all kinds of real integrals without using antiderivatives. So that's great. In this video, you will learn the general idea and you will see the general procedure that we are going to follow in all our examples. So what's the idea? Well, we will have some contour, which usually consists of the whole real axis or part of the real axis, that is called LR. I will have to close that contour. We can go up or we can go down. In this example, I put it up, a CR, but we get some closed contour. And our total contour we will call LR joined with CR. And our function f of z will be, well, if it's analytic everywhere, then the total integral will just vanish, so that would be silly. So usually we have some poles inside, z1, z2, etc., up to zk. And then we know that our total integral fz dz equals 2 pi I times the sum of the residues, some number. So what's the idea then? Well, this total integral is in this case going to consist of two parts, the one along LR and the one along CR. So the integral along LR will be the integral from minus R to R fx dx. That's the one we are looking for. It's some number, 2 pi I times the sum of the residues, which will be some number, so that's fine, minus the integral of along CR. And now the idea is that if this integral in limit R to infinity vanishes, that's a big if, that's always have to take care of that. If this integral vanishes, then you can take limits R to infinity on the left and right hand side. The integral here on the right hand side will cancel out. Here you have some number which you can compute, and on the left hand side you get the principal value of your real integral, which is the value you are looking for. So let us summarize the general procedure. First step, always very important step, you have some real function. You have to choose your f of z, smart, and you have to take your finite contour, also smart, such that you will in the end get the integral along CR to vanish. That's important. So you have to think ahead here. That one will have to vanish later on, and you will have to get back your real integral. So in step one, you really have to think ahead a few steps, like if you are playing chess or something like that. Just think a few moves ahead here. That requires some practice, so we'll do a lot of examples. Then, well, if you have done the thinking at step one, all the other steps are kind of automatic. You just follow the flow. Step two, you apply the theorem of residues and, well, check the conditions and compute the residues. So if you did step one correctly, step two will just be computing all the residues, and you check and you just verify that your conditions are indeed satisfied. Then step three, parameterize the LR, which should give you back some your real integral. That's really trivial in most of the cases. Step four, that's a big step, usually involves quite some work. You show that this integral along your big circular arc vanishes, so you have to get rid of some other integrals. In this case, show that one integral vanishes. And then step five, you wrap everything up, take the limits to infinity carefully, because you can end up with, for example, principal value, and then you have to show that if you're this principal value converges to your real integral. So here you have to put everything together, take limits carefully, and say something about the principal value. So those are the five steps you are always going to use in all the following examples of contour integrals.